What's poppin', YouTube? It's your boy Don P, the ape in the flesh, bringing you another game of Call of Duty World War II, playing with the MP40 with rapid fire grip and advanced rifling on a Mountaineer division using the Prime basic training. This is my first gameplay of today, and I didn't get like a lot of kills, but I decided to post it because I wanted to show you guys how I flank in domination. I find that domination game mode is one of the easiest modes to flank and to learn how to flank and move around the map. My boy Butney made a video is about flanking and showing you guys how I flank, and he's right on the video when he said that flanking is in a way the best way to get kills and maintain a KD in this game. You see a lot of times where I will get in a corner, like right now I'm in this corner, but it's because I expect enemy to be nearby, looking at the mini map, and I'm following the mini map and what's going on, and see where my teammates is at. And right now I find myself in enemy territory here. Now when I play domination, I tend to move around. When the game starts, I moved away from the B flag. Everybody charges towards B, and they take the closest route to B. And I flank. Look at your boy getting on the streaks here. When I flank, I go the longer way. I take the longer route to B. And the reason behind that is because I know that everybody is racing towards B. And if my teammates are doing this, most likely the enemy are doing the same thing. So there's going to be a face-off on B. In the meantime, your boy is playing it smart. He's taking the longest route, not really encountering too many enemies. And when they do come, you know, your boy's not the only smart player in Call of Duty. There's other smart players too. So sometimes I encounter one or two guys that are trying to do the same thing, and from the opposite side. But that's only one or two guys. Your boy can handle one or two guys, you know. So I clean the clocks, and now they know that I'm doing the same thing that I'm doing, that they doing. So I prepare myself to, you know, for revenge kills and whatnot. But that's a control situation. That's what I'm trying to get at. I flank in a way where I can control the situations that I get myself into. And that's the way I move around in domination, man. It's going on halftime. We're going to go on the second half right here. And you see I'm cashing B. I'm capturing B. And I'm moving. This time around, I decided to move this way. And it was just a mistake on my behalf. I didn't really recognize that the furthest way to B was the other side. Because on the first half of the game, you know, that's the route. The route even took a different route. Anyway, so I'm rushing towards Alpha here, and I'm being very cautious because I know my enemy spawn. I saw that guy over there, but I knew it didn't really, you know, matter for me. Now look at this. Oh man, damn man, I wish I had my boy Butney in that situation there, bro, because that noob that was with me, he was no help. But anyway, I'm playing the OBJ also, man. I'm trying to get to my score streaks. So I'm playing the OBJ but this is the main objective of the video is to show you guys how you flank. Now, there is two classes that I found to be the most successful classes to flank in Call of Duty on this game, on World War II, and that's the Mountaineer Division, because it silences your footsteps and it keeps you off the radar, and the Airborne Division. The problem with Mountaineer is that as soon as you fire your weapon, people see where you at. They can see that you your location, because you don't got no silencers. Airborne Division brings you the silencers, but people can hear your footsteps and people can actually see you on the UAV. So what I do is when I play with the Airborne Division, I put on inconspicuous to quiet my footsteps, and it works perfectly. And I use submachine gun for the suppressor. But I only use that class when I see that they're not really spamming UAVs. If the lobby's not spamming UAVs, then I slap on that class and I destroy the opposite team. I mean, I go bananas on them. It's a very, very strong class. You might want to try that. But when they are spamming UAVs left and right, then I slap on Mountaineer. And I gave myself a SMG, but this time around I put on Prime, because now I know, since they can see me in the mini map, or they can hear my weapon go off, I'm gonna encounter a lot of enemies, so I want to eliminate the flinching when I'm getting hit. Now this, look at this. I don't know. Let me show you something. I don't know how in the world I lost that gunfight. You can't win them all, bro. So that's what I do, man. Those are my two, pretty much so far, my two powerful flanking setups. My weapon of choice for flanking is the Type 100. I'm experimenting with other weapons. Like you see me in this match, I'm running with the MP40. The MP40 is okay. A lot of people like it. I told you in all the videos, the most OP weapon is the one that you feel more comfortable using, man. And I do okay with this, but I'd rather use the Type 100, man. The Type 100 slaps. It gives me a greater distance, and I'm able to dominate with it, man. So, anyway, man, like I said, it's not like the greatest, most kill-feed game you ever saw, but it's just a little piece of information. Another thing that have helped me on getting better at the games, Call of Duty games, is actually of looking at the way I play and see what I could do better and get more kills. Like I in this gameplay right here, I found myself being too passive. I could have played a little bit more aggressive. I could have switched to the Airborne Division, which allowed me to move faster and able to get to the spawns a little bit faster, and because there was no UAVs from the opposite team. So there's just a little mistakes here and there that I made, but it's my first game of the day, and eventually I cash on and change my playstyle a little bit. Now on TDM, this is a little bit different. In my opinion, we have revenge spawns in here, man. So TDM is a little bit more difficult for me to run around and flank them, spank them, But it can be done. Anything can be done. You just gotta be a little bit more cautious. Probably run Mountaineer more often, or trying to stay off the map. depending of how the enemy is playing. Anyway, thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Don't forget to hit the like button. Share the video if you like the video. And this is your boy Don P signing out. Salute.